Prodigy, today's your boy Shaver Speaks, man. Right now, I just gotta say this, man. Once again, another possibly powerful youth is taken down once again. And you guessed it. A high school football prodigy, destined for greatness, had a bright future ahead for himself. For those of you who have not heard, recently somewhere in Florida, I believe a high school junior was arrested for quote-unquote sexual related charges, and only he was charged with that. Now, the little girl's parents, little girl's parents said decided not to press any charges on him, but yet he's still detained. And correct me if I'm wrong, but I thought when you weren't detained, you can be set free, especially if parents decide not to press any charges on you. You should be set free. You should be all good. And plus, the kid guy wasn't the only one that was reporting and having sex with him. So why was only he the one singled out? I'll tell you why. Because every single time stuff like this happens, they always go by the popular, what I call the popular vote mentality. The person who has more to lose versus the people who don't have shit to lose. You know, he's a successful an all-around kind of guy, football star in high school, let's take him out. So now he's being charged on 3 lethal sex charges that shouldn't even be pinned upon him. And this is just the kind of thing that happens in our society, unfortunately. Any minority that sees himself having his own way, having a great path, and have something going for himself, he gets pinned up with sexual allegations against him and then some. I guess they're always so quick to press that button on us, man. We gotta stand together as people and fight against this kind of shit, man. We can't keep letting this shit happen. Frankly, you know, I understand that as black people, we grow up in poverty-stricken areas and then some. But sometimes that's either plays and puts us there innately, and then we also have the chance to get up out of those things. Sometimes we keep ourselves trapped in those kind of different difficulties and mentalities. In their mentalities, unfortunately. But anyway, I really hope that he seeks justice and gets his life back in order, because now his full ride to college, possibly, and everything that goes along with it is now in jeopardy because of those 3 sexual counts. The little girl was involved in sexual trafficking and sex slaves since she was 13 years old. So we'll see where this goes, but I hope nothing bad happens to him. Everything goes back to peaceful the way it was. And he shouldn't be the only one that's singled out. Him and all these other cronies and shit like that, they were doing some shit, but they weren't detained. Why? Because, as I said earlier, popular vote mentality. If you're really successful in school, and you're a minority or whatever like that, they're going to use that against you. You know, because, you know, they can't see any of us rising up, you know. That's just how it is, unfortunately. But this is your boy, Shaver Speaks. Subscribe to the channel. Like this video. Feel free to donate to the channel so I can give you guys more bomb-ass content. I love y'all. One love.